Hi friends, in this video we are going to see equivalent circuit diagram of a transformer. So this is the primary side of a transformer, and on secondary side the equivalent circuit diagram will look like this. This is a primary voltage V1, which will give rise to a primary current I1. That current will flow through primary winding resistance R1 and primary side leakage reactance X1. This I1 has two components: no load primary current, which is denoted as I0, and here the current which is responsible for nullifying the effect of phi2, which we call as I2 dash. Again, this I0 has two components. One is flowing through this resistance, which is called as core loss component of no load primary current, and this resistance is core loss resistance, which is responsible or denoted how much core loss is happening inside the core of a transformer. This is Xm, magnetizing reactance, and current flowing through it is I mu, which we call as magnetizing component of no load primary current I0. Because of flux phi, there will be EMF induced at the primary side, which is represented as E1, and that depends upon number of turns of primary winding. Same flux phi is linked through secondary turns N2, give rise to secondary induced EMF E2. And if I close the secondary winding through load ZL, there will be secondary side current I2, which will flow through secondary winding resistance R2 and secondary leakage reactance X2. So actually speaking, there are two circuits given like this, but in order to analyze the transformer, I can transform all the parameters to either side of a transformer, either a primary or secondary. That is called as equivalent circuit referred to primary side or equivalent circuit referred to secondary side. Before doing this, I will approximate this equivalent circuit. What I will do first, since this I1 is a vector current, so I1 bar is nothing but addition of these two currents, I0, which is a no load primary current, and I2 dash. Now this is no load primary current, hence it is very low. Normally it is 5 to 10% of full load current. So what happened? There will be a drop across this because of I1. Some part of I1 is I0, which is very, very less. So what I can do? I can say the drop across R1 and X1 is only because of I1. Since I'm saying this I0 is very low, I can say this I1 bar is approximately equal to I2 dash bar. So what I can do, I can interchange this part of a circuit with this, resulting in equivalent circuit, which we call as approximate equivalent circuit of a transformer, like this. What I have done? I have taken this part of a circuit before this. So this is V1. Now this will be I1. R1, X1, XM, RC. Here R2, X2. This current is I2. EMF induced is E1 at primary side. Secondary side it is E2, and voltage across this load resistance ZL is V2. Now this part of circuit will become redundant because this is across a known voltage V1. So now further I can reduce circuit like this. Primary voltage V1, primary current I1, primary winding resistance R1, primary leakage reactance X1, EMF induced E1. Similarly here EMF induced E2, secondary side resistance R2, secondary leakage reactance X2, current flowing through it I2, and voltage across load resistor is V2. So this will be a equivalent circuit diagram of a transformer that we can use for analysis purpose. Now what I want, all these parameters should be referred to one of the sides. So here comes the concept, equivalent circuit diagram of single phase transformer. First case referred to primary, and in second case it is referred to secondary. So as name suggests, referred to primary means all the elements should be at the primary side. So the circuit diagram will be like this. You will have only one resistance, and that is equivalent resistance referred to primary R1E, and only one reactance, equivalent leakage reactance referred to primary X1E, and I'll consider this load is also referred to primary ZL dash. So now I have to write equation for R1E. What is R1E? It's an equivalent resistance referred to primary. Since it is referred to primary, so I can write R1E equal to R1 plus. So I'm taking R2 from secondary side to primary. So it's R2 multiplied by, once again I repeat the statement, R2 referred from secondary to primary. So therefore it is N1 upon N2 square. Similarly, X1E is equivalent reactance referred to primary. So X1E is X1 plus X2 multiplied by N1 by N2 square. Now suppose I want to refer parameter to secondary side. So for that purpose, this is the equivalent circuit diagram we are having, and I want all these parameters should be referred to secondary side. So let's see if I refer to a secondary side. So if I'm referring, I will have only one resistance, one leakage reactance and load like this. So this will be EMF induced at the secondary side E2, current flowing through the secondary winding R2, resistance will be equivalent resistance referred to secondary side, so it's R2E, and leakage reactance referred to secondary is X2E. Load resistance is ZL, or I can say load impedance is ZL, and V2 is the load voltage or terminal voltage. So what will be the equation of R2E? What is R2E? R2E is equivalent resistance referred to secondary. So R2 will remain as it is, because now we are at the secondary winding. So R2 will be as it is. But component of R1, primary resistance referred to secondary, will be like this. R1 referred to secondary. Hence N2 upon N1 square. Similarly, X2E is equivalent reactance referred to secondary. So the equation is X2E equal to X2 plus X1. I am referring to secondary, hence N2 upon N1 square. Now, any one circuit we can take for analysis purpose. Once again, I'll tell you what is R1E. It's an equivalent resistance referred to primary. If I know R1 and R2, I can get R1E like this. R1E equal to R1 plus R2 into N1 by N2 square. Similarly, X1E, equivalent reactance referred to primary, and is given by X1 plus X2 into N1 upon N2 square. If I refer all the parameters to secondary side, R2 is called as the equivalent resistance referred to secondary and given as R2 plus R1 into N2 by N1 square. Similarly, X2E, equivalent reactance referred to secondary, given as X2 plus X1 into N2 by N1 square. So now, instead of seeing this complicated diagram, keeping all the concepts intact, I can refer any one of the diagrams, either refer to primary or refer to secondary, in order to calculate transformer parameters, example, efficiency. Thank you.